Hank Grift. I'm 38 years old. I'm training in Kevlar. It's an old naval base from America. Very nice training complex. I've been starting with horses when I was 14 years old, 15. My father always was a big trainer. In the beginning, I was not so interested to be in the horses, but after a while, I thought it was more fun. I took the step and decided I started on my own. So I'm an own trainer since 2001. That's about 12 years now. And in the beginning, it was very hard because when you have a famous father, people always try to compare you, and it seems like it's sometimes not so easy because everybody look more at you than on other people because you come from a famous family or famous father. So in the beginning it was difficult, but now we have it going, and we train around 68 horses, and that's going very well. I'm satisfied, and I can't complain. Okay. It's the name of my wife and my daughter on the helmet. And you know what stands behind? You know what is standing there?
No.
It stands on Holland. One day not laughing is one day not living. You need to make a little bit fun, Jan. When I took over the stable in 2001, in the beginning I had very good success. And the first year we was winning like 80 or 90 races. I trained 45 horses, and the years after I made a lot of mistakes. I thought I don't have to work so much to get success, and I lost a lot of clients. So I went down for 3-4 years. It was really bad. I started to buy and sell horses to at least make a living. And then I have two good friends, Fabrice Steil and Jean-François Mailleur. And they've been helping me a lot, and through Fabrice Steil, of course, I was getting King Prestige in my stable. And after when I get King Prestige, Lisbeth Vinaire, my winner, it started to change for me. Then I had success with them, they did good, and after that, because they were horses, you go to Zuvalawit or to Oslo, you go outside your own country, you get some success, and then you also get some little bit more respect of the people. And then slowly we came up and up. We started to get more horses, and yeah, last year was the best year. We took almost like €1 million in purse money, and we've been winning in every racetrack we come to. So now it's going very good, and of course when it's going good you get better horses. So now the important thing is to keep the same level and try to make it even better than last year. It's this place here, it's very beautiful. It has a 1,200 meter track with very beautiful turns. It's actually built like a racetrack. It's perfect to train. The ground is perfect. It's not too deep, but not too hard either, because I prefer a track who is a little bit tight. I don't like a track that's very deep, because I think you get a lot of problem in the suspensor and in the tendon. So I prefer, but I also don't want it too hard. I try to find a middle way. And then I have a very beautiful straight line. That's like, I can go 3,000 meters straight, but I only train 800 meters interval. It's actually on this place, it's so big. It's a little bit, like well, not so beautiful and not that big. But I'm just here with another trainer, and for me it works perfect. We have results, and I'm very happy to be here.
Go 5 interval, Jan.
No, well, at least it's like this. I always say to my owners, the horses, they are bump free, so that don't happen nothing with them. And the bunkers, they're very nice, because in the summer when it's hot, they are cool inside, because they isolated very good. And when it's cold in the winter time, it's a nice temperature in the bunkers. So I think the horses, they feel really well in the bunkers. Of course, it's very important you know a lot of people, and I'm very lucky that I know a lot of people, because I've been traveling already around since I was 17. And good contacts always brings you to good horses or to good business. So of course it's important to have good contacts everywhere. And also in other countries, I have a lot of people who can help me out. Klaus Koch from Denmark, he's a friend of mine. He helps me with a lot of things. And it's like on every strange country you do business or you want to be with, you need people that help you, because on your own it's too difficult. You can always do something better, because in this business you learn every day. You're never too old to learn, but I try to you get experience when you travel a lot, but that doesn't mean you don't make no mistakes. But I try to make it almost perfect, and I have a lot of help on my wife. She helps me in the stable. I got good horses on my stable, and when I have good horses, I have good people who work for me.
Comme Hank Grift a très bon résultat en France, c'était pour voir un petit peu sa méthode d'entraîner, tout ça. Et comme il a quelques chevaux quand même à monter, que ce soit en France ou en Suède, un petit peu en Allemagne, ça m'intéressait de faire un peu le tour, de voir comment ça se passe.
Alors c'est un challenge, parce que finalement tu aurais pu trouver un entraîneur français et courir qu'en France. Ce qui te plaît, c'est un petit peu de voyager.
Ouais, j'aime bien voyager. En France, j'aurais pu trouver, mais bon, il y a beaucoup d'entraîneurs, c'est vrai, mais bon, il n'y a pas des très très... beaucoup d'entraîneurs qui font confiance aux jeunes. Quand on n'est pas trop dans la famille, dans les chevaux, c'est assez compliqué.
Yeah, well, it goes well for the moment, but there's always something you can do better. But I think that's everybody has that. No, I prefer to stay here. My daughter, she goes to the school here, and she's 11 years old. So I prefer to stay here. My wife is happy here. I'm happy here. Okay, we have to travel a lot. But I also have a lot of Dutch customers and Dutch horses in training. I still have German horses, so my bases will be here. Now we have good owners and we have a lot of purse money. Well, last year we took 1 million, this year maybe 700,000-800,000. So we have good customers. I have very nice horses. So at the moment it's for me, it's very good, but if you must survive from the purse money in Holland with 500 euros on the winner, or like in Germany for 700-800 on the winner, it's really difficult. And I know that the Dutch people and also the German people, and especially the Dutch, they are very happy on the PMU meetings. They in Wolvega, I think they go from November till March, then they have like 3,000 euro on the winner each race. And then it's a little bit easier to survive in this country, because otherwise it's really hard. I have a good life because now I have a big stable and everything. But for the small people, they have no life very young. How can they cannot survive? It's impossible. They're dead. For me, I take 1,000 euro. But some I know, one trainer in Holland, they take 300. Yeah, then you... it's nothing to do. I take 1,000 euro and I take the prize money. And a lot of good horses, they are myself. I own half of Prince de Montfort now. I have Titan de Jong, Ciao Love, I have 50%. Lottie's Photo, 50%. Last year, my own horse, they take 250,000. Only my own horse. So for me, I'm okay, but if you have a small trainer who train for 300 here. No. I don't know how they do it, to be very honest. I don't know, I only say to her, we win a lot. And we invest a lot in our stable, we on the camionettes, in the sulkies, everything. But I say many times to my wife, I don't understand how the other people make their living. It's for me, it's amazing how some people survive. I am my winner. Yeah. It's his friend, they always are together.
Hey.
Always. They're always together. Hey, come on. Oh, my God.